Hey guys, welcome back to another video. Today I'll be showing from start to finish how to make a simple character in Blender. So we'll start with creating a mesh, then adding an armature, and in the end we'll add an animation, and I'll show you how to export it properly for use in Unreal Engine 4. Let's get right into Blender.
All right, so the first thing you're going to want to do is open up a clean Blender file. And what I also did was import the UE4 mannequin into my scene, just as a scaling reference. You can see more about this in my previous video. Now, one more thing before we get started. I always like to use these moving arrows, which are called the move gizmos. And to enable them, you go to this top right menu, click on the drop down arrow and check this move box. Now we can easily move this guy to the side and get started on our actual model. All right, so we'll first start with the head by using this default cube, going into edit mode by pressing tab. And on the top left of your screen, go to face select mode, which is a bit easier to use for this character. Scale it down, and this is going to be the head, so drag it up a bit. Next, we're going to add his torso by pressing Shift A, also add a new cube. Scale this down, then I go to forward facing view, drag this under the head, and make it a bit slimmer than his head, like so. And drag his torso down so it's a bit longer. And I also want to make it a bit slimmer, so I just hover my mouse over this object, press L, I select everything, and I'm going to scale it in the Y direction by pressing S and Y, make him a bit slimmer. All right, next onto his arms. So press Shift A once you're in object mode again. And to make sure you're in object mode or edit mode, look at the top left, you can see object mode. Once I am in object mode, simply press Shift A, add a new mesh, a cube. And a neat little trick in order to duplicate the arms on both the left side and the right side at the same time, just add a modifier. So go to the right panel, go to modifier properties, add modifier, and add a mirror modifier. So now once we go back into edit mode by pressing tab and selecting everything by pressing A, I'm going to scale this down by pressing S and scaling. Go to the front view, and if you press G, you get the free moving tool. So press G, drag it out, and now we immediately have two blocks which are mirrored on both the left and the right side. Scale this down a bit. These are going to be his arms. A bit lower, on the same level as his shoulders. Look underneath it and drag this down. So that looks about right. Press tab to go back to object mode. And we're going to duplicate these arms to be his legs. So press Shift D. As you can see, I have a hold of these. Now press escape. So they're in the same position. Go back into edit mode by pressing tab. Then press A to select everything. Go to the front facing view and then press G and now drag them underneath his body. Maybe scale them down a bit, make them a little slimmer so they fit nicely next to his body. Then from the underneath, just make them a little longer. And I'm gonna drag these up just a tiny bit. All right, so now we have a pretty nice looking character. He looks very much like the Minecraft Steve character. What we're going to want to do now is apply the mirror modifiers because we don't need them anymore. Just simply select the arms, go to the right panel and apply. Do the same for the legs, select them, right panel, apply. Now he's floating a bit and all his arms and stuff are like they're disconnected. So we're going to want to connect them by selecting everything, holding shift and selecting them. And then press Ctrl J. Now he's just one simple object. As you can see, there's just one object in the scene collection. I'm gonna call him cube guy. And he's also floating, so we wanna bring him down. So go select the character, press tab to go into edit mode, select everything with A, and then from the front view by either pressing this button or number one on your numpad, if you have that on your keyboard, drag him down until he's right on the red line.
Great, so with the mesh done, it is now time to move on to adding bones to our character. We do this by adding what is called an armature. This allows mesh objects to have flexible joints and is what Unreal uses for the skeleton. Since I am making a very simple blocky character with no bending arms or legs, the skeleton is also going to be very simple. Of course, when creating your own character, you can be as creative as you want, which will also result in different looking skeletons. This is all fine since in Unreal Engine you can easily import and use custom skeletons. If you want to know how to set up your own custom character in Unreal Engine, from importing to actually making it walk, then check out our newest video in which Wim will take you through all the steps. Now let's get started on adding our first bone.
So I'm going to go back to the forward facing view. In object mode, press Shift A, then go to armature. We get this bone and it's quite big. I'm going to go into tab edit mode again, select everything and scale it down. And now, as you can see, it's pretty hard to see it through the mesh. So go back into object mode. And with the bone selected, go to the right and go to this panel, the object data. Go to the viewport display and select in front. So now we can see the bone through the mesh and it's easier to work with. All right, select the bone again. Go to edit mode, scale, pull this up. Then I want to make this as big as his torso. And then by pressing E, I'm going to extend another bone out of this bone. And pressing C, we're going to restrict it to the Z axis. So it's just going to go up, make it about as big as his head. And now we want to make some arms and leg bones. So press this, press E, drag it out. Now we want to detach this bone by selecting the bone in the middle, then pressing Alt P and clearing the parent. So now it's separated from these two bones. And if I want to drag this out, I can simply drag it out. All right, select this and pull this down or press G so you can freely move it. Make this a bit straight. Select the bone and duplicate it by pressing Shift D, drag it to his leg. And we're simply going to select this one, and duplicate it to the other side. And just place them on top of the mesh. I want to make sure that the arm bones and the leg bones are connected to the main root bone, because you'll see later on that they have to be connected in order for the character to work properly. So select the bone, select the top of this bone, press Ctrl P to parent it, and make sure you press Keep Offset. See a little line coming on, and that's what we need so we can see that everything is connected. Do the same for the leg bones. Now everything is parented to the root bone, and we're ready to move on to naming the bones. Just select each and every bone, go to the right panel, go to this bone icon, and here you can set the name for the bone. So this is going to be the head. This is going to be his root. This is the arm.r, or actually this is the left arm, because we're looking at the front of the character, and from the back it's the left arm. Name it the same on the other side, arm.r, which is the right arm, and then also leg.l, leg.l. So now that everything has been named correctly, it's time to actually connect the bones to the mesh or to the body, so we can move the body with the bones. So go back to object mode by pressing tab. First select the mesh, then select the armature, which is pretty important because we want to parent the mesh to the armature, not the other way around. And then once you've got both selected, press Ctrl P and select armature deform with automatic weights. Click that, and now nothing, it seems as if nothing happened. But if we click the armature, go in the top left, go to pose mode, click one of these and rotate this, for example, we can see that the mesh now successfully deforms with the way the bones move. So just check everything. You can see everything is connected. And because I connected the arms and the legs to the root bone, they move with the root bone. So when I move the root bone, everything just goes along with it. Just check if everything works. And everything was successful. If we want to reset this pose, just press A to select everything. And using Alt R, we can reset the rotation. All right, now that we have successfully added a skeleton or an armature, we can actually start making animations. So in order to do that, we go back into object mode, just deselect everything. And on the top panel of Blender, you can see animation. This is where we make animations. So what I like to use is on the bottom left of this screen, go to action editor, and here we can add multiple actions, which would be, for example, walking or an idle animation, or maybe a running animation. But I'm just going to add a simple walking and idle animation for now. So you have to think about the amount of frames you're going to use for an animation. And to keep things simple, I'm just going to tell you that for the running animation or the walk animation, we're going to use 16 frames. As you can see, it's been set to 16 frames. This has been highlighted. And now we can just move the bones and it's going to record everything by pressing this button at the bottom, auto keying. Set this one to 1. And the first pose we're going to want to make is the actual running pose. So select the bone, make sure you are in pose mode in the top left by pressing R, We can rotate this leg and we want to constrain it to the X axis. So let's make sure everything is straight. Move this backward, do the opposite for this leg, and then make sure his arms are also in the correct position. And this is his first pose. As you can see, you get a little couple of dots here, and we select everything by pressing A. You see it has automatically added all the keyframes because we selected the record mode. Now go to the last frame, or actually select these by just dragging them. Control copy, go to the last frame, which is frame 16 for this animation, paste it. And now we have the start frame and the end frame. And in the middle frame, we're gonna just make this same position, but in the opposite way. So select his legs again, press RX just to move it along this X axis. And like this, it's just gonna be the same position pretty much, but the opposite way. And make sure this is in the middle of the frames. So we have 16 frames, put this at 8. Now when we play it, we have the walking animation. So it's simple as that. Just the first frame and the last frame have to be the same animation, and then the middle frame has to be the opposite or of either the first or the last frame. Next, we're going to also make a simple idle animation by making a new action with this button, a new action button, naming that idle. This is going to be 120 frames because we want it to be a bit slower. And we can simply select all the bones, delete the keyframes by pressing X, delete keyframes. And then the first position we want is the head a bit turned. Or actually, the first position we want is in back to normal. So select everything, press Alt R to reset all the rotations. And then automatically set a couple of keyframes because we have the record button on. Now we just want the head to move a tiny bit to the left on the first frame. So press R and then Z, and you can move it on the Z axis. So just a tiny bit to the left. Then select these frames, Control copy, move to the last frame, Control V. And the same as before, go to the middle frame, which is a 60 of 120, and move the head a bit to the right. So now when we play it, we also have very slow idle animation. All right, so far we have successfully made the mesh. We've created the armature. We have actually attached the armature to the mesh, and now we were able to make animations with them. We have two animations. We have an idle animation with a very simple head movement from left to right. And if we select the armature, go to the running animation, set this to 16 frames. We also have the running animation. Before we export the character, I just want to add a very simple material to add a bit more color to him. I'm back in layout mode and I select the mesh, go to the material tab, and here you can see there's no material attached currently, so press new. It adds a new material and we can change the color here to whatever we want. So let's say blue. And now we don't see anything happening. That's because if you press Z, you can see we are in solid mode and you need to go to either material preview mode or rendered. But since we have no lights, you will not see the correct color. So go to material preview and you can easily preview the color you select here on the right. So I want to make him a bit less blue, or at least a bit less dark blue. Maybe something like this. All right. So now we've also added a simple material. This will transfer over to Unreal. And let me show you the correct export settings. One of the first things and most important things you want to check before exporting your character and armature to Unreal is if the armature name has been changed to something else. Because by default, if you click on the armature and look in the top right in the scene collection, you can see that Blender names the armature armature. However, if you export it like this, then Unreal will not recognize the armature correctly and the skill will be completely wrong. So the only thing you have to do is change this name, just double click it to something else. It can be anything except armature. So for example, skeleton. Now we are ready to finally export our character. So all you want to do from this point is select the mesh and select the armature or the skeleton. Go to File, Export, FBX. Save it to where you want with the name you want it to be called. Click Selected Objects. We only want the armature and the mesh. Apply the units. The rest is all okay. Under Geometry, go to Smoothing and select Face. And armature, make sure to deselect add leaf bones and set it to only deform bones. We only want the deformation bones. And finally, we want to make sure that bake animations is checked. and the rest is all okay. So just simply press export FBX, and that's it. We've exported the FBX file. And just as a last check to make sure we did everything correctly, import the FBX file we just exported, drag it into the Explorer. You see all the settings are correct. Just make sure that import animations is also selected. Press import all. And as you can see, it has successfully imported the character without any errors. We get both animations. And if we drag this into the viewer, it works.
So guys, hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Now you know how to make a character from scratch in Blender and use the correct export settings for using Unreal Engine 4. And if you want to know how to replace the standard Unreal Engine 4 mannequin with the character you just made, then be sure to check out our other video linked down below, where we show you how you can replace the mannequin with your own custom character. Oh, by the way guys, you can also download the file I made in this video. The download link is in the description down below. Anyways, thanks for watching. See you guys in the next video.